This just in to CNN, an unnerving sight today at a London Gay Pride celebration, an ISIS flag among a sea of rainbow colors. CNN International Simon Editor spotted the flag and was able to snap these pictures. Joining me on the phone from London is CNN's International Lucy Paul and CNN National Security Analyst Peter Bergen. So Lucy, I want you to start off explaining and describing what you saw and the reaction to it.
Hi there, Suzanne. Yes, I was just leaving work and I came across the Gay Pride March, an annual event in London where tens of thousands of people march through London. It's a very jovial, lighthearted atmosphere, very happy atmosphere. And I was just trying to cross Regent Street, one of the main shopping streets in London, and I had to stop because the march was going down the street, when all of a sudden this man, quite distinctive from the rest of the crowd, he was dressed in black and white, whereas everyone else was brightly colored, as you can see from the photos. Mm. This man dressed in black and white was waving what appears to be a very bad mimicry, but a clear attempt to mimic the ISIS flag, the black and white flag with the distinctive lettering. I mean, if you look at the flag closely, it's clearly not Arabic. In fact, it looks like it could be gobbledygook, but it's very distinctive, the ISIS flag. Anyway, I seem to be the only person who had spotted this. And nobody seems to be raising any questions or pointing it out. So I immediately went to an event organizer who said he didn't know anything about it. I also spoke to the police nearby who weren't aware either. Now, bear in mind that there was heightened security today at this event because after the devastating terrorist attacks that happened yesterday in Tunisia, where we now know that at least 15 Britons have been killed. So it was an extremely strange and unnerving thing to see. If it was a political statement of some sort, it was very subtle. There was no sort of rainbow color. There was no sort of, you know, red cross through it. It was very subtle, and us Brits are known for our subtle sense of humor. But I'm not sure that everyone, if they had spotted it, might have thought it was particularly amusing.
Yeah, that's a good point, Lucy. And I have a couple of follow-up questions for you. First of all, the security, you said the security is particularly tight because of these terrorist attacks that we saw over on three different continents just in the last several days on one day. So describe what the security situation is down at this large march. And then the second question is whether or not there was any follow in terms of trying to find this guy and figure out what he was doing.
Sure. So, I mean, in general, the event, the Gay Pride event, and I certainly saw it when I was down there, the atmosphere was very relaxed and laid back. It's a very happy atmosphere, but there were noticeably police around, and the police had confirmed that they were putting on heightened security. It's also coincidentally Armed Forces Day here in the UK. So I'm sure it was coincided with that as well. Mm-hmm. But so, I mean, there was a noticeable police presence, but it wasn't overbearing. And there was police in general here don't tend to carry guns, and there were no guns I couldn't see. But there were police vans and police milling about. The first policeman I came across, I immediately, but the policeman there did say that they were worried that people would take offense on any day, really, but particularly on a day after these awful terrorist attacks, and we're hearing from the Prime Minister that, you know, we're preparing for more and more British deaths.
All right, Lucy, thank you so much. I want to get Peter Bergen in this conversation. And Peter, so, you know, from a national security point of view here, does this bother you? Does it concern you? Should people there in that crowd be concerned? Should somebody be following this guy and figuring out what he was doing there?
Yeah, I mean, well, the main question is, what are his motivations? I mean, it could be some kind of, you know, almost parody. It's possible. After all, you know, I mean, you know, one of ISIS's principal goals in territories it controls is to murder gays. In fact, yesterday on a Twitter feed out of Raqqa, which is the de facto capital of ISIS in Syria, There was footage of ISIS hurling to their certain deaths four homosexual men from tall buildings, which is the way that they kill gays, that ISIS kills gays. So it's also a very strange place to be showing an ISIS flag, since ISIS, one of ISIS's principal goals is to kill gays. So the whole thing is very strange.
Strange it may be. It may be a parody as well. But in light of what you just said, that ISIS has thrown gays over the ledge there, and their point of view when it comes to gays, could this be a warning? Could it be a sign? Could it be a flag of sorts of, hey, you know what? This is our next location. This is our next attack.
Yeah, it could also be, you know, this is my kind of strange way of putting a thumb in the eye of ISIS. It's just like, since we don't know who this person is, we don't know their motivations, it's hard to say. But it's a particularly strange place to be flying an ISIS banner for the reasons we've just discussed.
Mm-hmm. Peter, do you think it could possibly be somebody in the parade itself participating and the gay community mocking ISIS in their point of view?
Yeah, I mean, that's not out of the question.